Hello everyone, welcome to the very special episode of Indian Curries and Pickles. Today is Teachers' Day, a day dedicated in honor of teachers, and I'm fortunate to celebrate this show in recognition of all the diligent teachers of our country, as they are educating and molding young students and thus the future of this country. When we think about our teachers, a sweet, tingling memory of school teachers occur to our mind. My most favorite teacher was my bio teacher. Unfortunately, we are not in touch anymore. So I asked my little one to ask her teacher about her favorite dish. She happens to be a Kashmiri, and she said her favorite dish is Kashmiri dum aloo. So let's make this hallmark dish from Kashmir for her and all the amazing teachers out there. So let me introduce you to the ingredients first. Kashmiri cuisine uses very limited spices. Let me introduce you to the magic box of Kashmir. So these are very few spices which they often use. This is fennel powder, these are bay leaves, this is saunt or dry ginger powder, this is star anise, and these are green cardamom, and this is long or cloves. This is curd, it's the main base ingredient for the gravy. These are boiled potatoes, or I should say parboiled potatoes. These are fried potatoes, I've already done it. But I'll show you how do we fry potatoes. The art is in frying potatoes only. We'll boil the potatoes, not fully. Keep it little hard and then prick them like this. Meanwhile, we'll heat the mustard oil. Let the oil smoke properly. I've seen many quick fix recipes for dum aloo, specifically Kashmiri dum aloos. But let me tell you, it takes 45 minutes to fry Kashmiri dum aloos, and it becomes like this after 45 minutes of frying. It becomes hollow from inside. I've seen many recipes where they say you just shallow fry it or you just bake it. But guys, if you're making Kashmiri dum aloos, please make it the way Kashmiris make it. The only drawback of this dish is that you require a liter of oil. Now oil has started smoking. All you have to do is add a pinch of hing. So now I'll gently put potatoes inside the oil for frying. Keep the flame high in the beginning. Meanwhile, let's do preparation for our gravy. Mix curd evenly, and now let's add this fennel powder. Keep the bay leaves, rest would go inside the curd. Mix it well. The fennel powder gives the main aroma to the dish. Now it's evenly mixed. Let's start preparing gravy. See, the potatoes have started turning golden brown, but don't think they are done. At this stage, we will keep them on a low flame and we'll let it fry for another 30 to 40 minutes. If you see, the potatoes are turning very brown, there is a tip. Take little water in your hand and sprinkle over it. The temperature of the oil will go down. From the same wok, we'll take some oil for the gravy. Add bay leaves, some green cardamom, some cloves. And if you have saffron at home, you can also add few strands of saffron. It will give beautiful aroma to the dish. Keep stirring the potatoes on the other side. So now this oil is hot. All we have to do is, we have to add this curd mixture, the cardamom and fennel smells so heavenly. Keep whisking till the mixture starts boiling. For potatoes, keep the flame as low as possible. Let them properly deep fry. Now you can see the gravy has started boiling. Now we will add some salt. Let it thicken a bit. Kashmiri food has a lot of oil, but they digest it very well because of the high altitude and because of the climatic conditions they live in. Their every dish literally has gravy of oil. They hardly add any water to it. This side, see, our potatoes have become nice and crispy and golden brown. This is how your potatoes should look like, and they will literally melt in your mouth, I tell you. So friends, our potatoes are almost ready to go inside the gravy. Now we will keep the lid for 5 minutes and keep the flame on low at this point. If you feel the curd gravy is a bit thick, you can add little water, not too much. Let it cook for another 5 minutes. So now you can see the layer of oil over the dish. So our dum aloo is almost ready. Now we only have to give the last finishing touch. So friends, this is the last ingredient which I'm going to add to my Kashmiri dum aloo. This is special Kashmiri masala available in Kashmir and Jammu region. If you can't get this masala, you can also use desi ghee and just put some red chilies and saffron into it and give the final tempering. So now I've taken some leftover oil from the wok in which I fried my potatoes. Let it smoke for a while. I'm going to add this special Kashmiri masala for flavor. This gives vibrant color to the dish. In case you don't have it and you like mild curry, so you can have the dish as it is. But I like the flavor of this masala very much. Now the dum aloo is almost ready. You can see the oil in the corners. That means dish is perfectly done. Now I'm going to add a little bit of this masala over it. See, I haven't added any red chilies or any kind of chili in this dish. So this masala gives that spicy tinge to the dish. And the gravy is mostly like this pale green color. This color comes from the cardamom and the fennel powder. Now our dum aloos are almost ready. I'm going to plate it and serve it with boiling hot rice. So if you want to make it more colorful, you can add a little more tempering over it. And also if you have dry pudina at home, you can also add some dry pudina over it. Friends, this dish is a bit oily, but that's the way it is. So teachers, this is my small tribute to all of you out there. I know in these difficult times, you all are working very hard. All we can do is we can wish more power to you. I hope you all are back to school soon, as your students are fed up of our home food. Bye-bye.